We shall construct predictive parsing table for the grammar. S produces WAB or ABCS, A produces B or WB, B produces YB or epsilon, C produces Z, and W produces X. First of all, we shall have to find first and follow sets for this grammar. Now, for the first set, we shall write the first set which we can find easily. Here, W produces X. So, first of W will be X, and C produces Z. So, first of C will be Z. First of V, YB. Y is terminal here. So, first of B will be Y from this production, and epsilon. If we use B produces epsilon, then first of B will be epsilon. A is depending on B. If we take this production, first of A will be same as first of B, which is Y and epsilon. If we take this production, E produces WB, then first of A will be same as that of W. So what is first of W? C. So sorry, first of W is X. So I will add X here. First of S. If we use this production, first of S will be same as that of W, which is X. So I will use X here. If we take this production, first of S will be same as that of A, which is X, Y and epsilon. X is already written, Y is there. If A is replaced with epsilon, then first of S will be same as that of B, because A will be vanished. So first of S will be same as that of B, and first of B is Y and epsilon. Y has already been written there. So when B is replaced with epsilon, B will also be vanished. So first of S will be same as that of C, which is Z here. So I will write Z here. So first of S is XYZ, first of A X, Y and epsilon, first of B, Y and epsilon, first of C, Z, first of W, X here. Now, we have to find follow of S. We know S is the start symbol and it is not coming into the right hand side. Yes, it is coming here. So, we shall see. Follow of S will be dollar because it is the start symbol. And we know S is coming here. Whenever we have to find the follow of non-terminal which is appearing, which is at the rightmost side, so its a follow will be same as that of S. It can be seen from here. Follow of S is dollar. If I pop this S and push this statement ABCS, ABCS, there is no effect on this S. Follow of this S is dollar. So that has already been written. I have explained it. Whenever you have the non-terminal at rightmost side, then its follow will be same as that of the symbol from which it has been produced. So follow of S is dollar, and this S is also rightmost non-terminal. Its follow will be same as that of S. So its follow is dollar. So I am writing only dollar here. Now we have to find the follow of A. follow of A will be same as first of B here. First of E is Y and epsilon. If I write Y here, it's okay. If B is replaced by epsilon, B will be vanished. Then this will be same as WA. S produces WA. B will be vanished there. So A's follow will be same as that of S. If I take this production, so follow of S is dollar. I am writing dollar here. If I take this production, follow of A is same as first of B. And first of B is Y, which has been written here. If Y is replaced with epsilon, then follow of A will be first of C because B will be vanished. So first of C is Z. So I am writing Z here. Nowhere else A is coming. Now follow of B. Follow of B, if I use this production, follow of B will be same as that of S. So follow of S is dollar. I am writing here. And follow of B will be same as first of C. First of C is Z. I am writing Z here. And follow of B, if I use this production, follow of B will be same as that of A. Because that is the rightmost. That is the only symbol. I can say that this is also the rightmost non-terminal which is being produced by A. So follow of B will be same as that of A. Dollar and Z is there. I have to write Y here. Yes. And B is coming here, so no need to write here. Now follow of C. If I use this production, follow of C will be same as first of S. First of S is X, Y, Z. So I will write X, Y and Z here. Now follow of W. If I use this production, follow of W is same as first of A. First of A is X, Y and epsilon. X, Y and epsilon. If I replace this A with epsilon, follow of W will be same as first of B, which is Y, which has already been written there. If this B is also replaced by epsilon, then A and B both will be vanished. Then S will produce W only. In this case, follow of W will be same as that of S, which is dollar. So I am writing dollar here. And where W is coming? Yes, here. If yes, follow of W is first of B. First of B is Y and epsilon. Y has already been written there. And if I replace this B with epsilon, its follow will be same as that of A, which is Y, Z and dollar. Y is there. Z is not there. Dollar is already there. So follow of W will be X, Y, Z and dollar. Now, we have to construct predictive parsing table for this grammar. Now we know terminals are X, Y, Z and dollar only. So I am writing here X, Y, Z and dollar. Non-terminals are S, A, B, C and W. When shall I get X? If I take this production, S produces WAB, I will get X because W is directly producing X. So I will write in this cell, this production S produces WAB. Now, if I take this production, what shall I get? First off is x, y and epsilon. Whenever x, y is needed, I will write here, S produces AB CS and S produces AB CS. Because A is also producing Y and X. So I can write both the productions here. And for Z, if A is epsilon, B is epsilon, first of C will be Z. So I will write this production only. S will produce A, B, C and S. Because if A is replaced with epsilon, B is replaced with epsilon, first of S will be same as first of C, which is Z. So I have to use this production here. Now, first of A is Y, X and epsilon. If I need B, if I need Y, I will use this production. A produces B. If I need X, I will use this production. Because first of W is X, so A produces W, B. Now, epsilon is also there in first set, so I have to write this production in this set. In these cells, Y dollar and Z, Y dollar and Z here. But I know I am not directly getting epsilon using A. So I have to write B here because I am getting epsilon through B. So I will use A produces epsilon. A produces B, sorry. A produces B here. If I need Y, I will use this production. If I need epsilon, I will use this production. Okay. Now, for B. If I need Y, I will use this production, YB. B produces YB. And epsilon is also there in its first, so I will use epsilon in these cells. Dollar, B produces epsilon. Z, B produces epsilon. And Y, B produces epsilon. And first of C is Z, and Z is being produced by C directly. C produces Z, and W produces X. In this cell, W produces X. This is the predictive parsing table for this grammar, and we can see easily there are some cells which are containing multiple entries, more than one entry. So this grammar is not LLM.